I'm making the wood stove from two rotors. They're just gonna facing upside down each other. Wood is gonna be burned here, and also I can use it as propane stove. Easy. And first I pre-drill the holes, and then I'm gonna use a grinder to make a clean cut. And safety first. Hey guys, this is how you bend a plate around so it's gonna become a door, because it's gonna go all the way around and become a door. Two rotors facing each other kind of upside down like flying saucer, and I cut little hole here so I can put the wood inside, kind of like a door, and the spinning door to close it. And this is the chimney, and the muffler pipe goes on top of it. Hey guys, this is the test of my self-made burning stove. So I found this aluminum tin chimney in a builder surplus store between a scrap of the metal table, garden table, and all this underneath it has a propane stove. So you can run this heater on a propane, or you can use propane to dry the wood on top of it. And where is the divider inside of the rotors that prevent ashes from falling on a propane stove? It was freezing. The water froze. We saw the ice here and bison windshield and everything. But I'm stuck because I need to fix my van so I can escape and go to Florida. And the only thing keep me alive last night is my heater. I made the heater myself. I'm using right now with the propane, and also I can use with the wood or any other. I can use with any other fuels, including the fancy camping gears, fuel like that. I can use with that. You guys have to buy them in bulk, the whole big box, then it's gonna be reasonable. Or I can do with a coal, smokeless coal or smokeless wood they have for barbecue. That's gonna work fine for that. And you guys would say, what you doing? You're gonna die from carbon monoxide. Carbon monoxide go like that over there in a lid from the pan. And that lid have a hole like that, and I touch and it's become my chimney. So it's protected from the rain, but also my carbon monoxide disappear. Hole in my floor, and I burning outside oxygen, so would never deplete. And also I bring this oxygen with my USB fan. I put my USB fan over there, and I push in my air from outside to the chimney, and no oxygen depletion. So gonna survive.